The Royal Scottish Academy presents 10 dialogues, Richard de Marco, Scotland and the European Avant-Garde, on the year of his 80th birthday, and 2 days before a major exhibition celebrating his life and work, he received the Cross of the Order of Merit of the Federal Republic of Germany and the Polish Bene Merito Award.
The Bene Merito Award is given by the Minister of Foreign Affairs for the great achievement to promote Poland abroad. And Richard de Marco is a man who is really building bridges between countries.
The exhibition is taking place in the upper gallery spaces of the Royal Scottish Academy building on the Mound in Edinburgh, and will feature work by 10 artists whom have had established dialogues with Richard de Marco.
The reason why we chose the title 10 Dialogues for this exhibition was to reflect that his notion of art and of culture is founded upon meetings, upon dialogue. Richard de Marco has spent much of his life trying to overcome the divisions left by the Second World War and by the Cold War. He's attempted to overcome those divisions in the cultural sphere.
Also, we wanted the exhibition not to be packed with lots of little things. We wanted every work to be there for a reason. Each room would tell a different story. And to be able to take the biggest space in the gallery and have the one work by Abakanovich was just fabulous for us. I mean, we went to meet her in Warsaw, and she was so committed to the idea of the show. 80 years old this year, shows all over the world, and she gave us the biggest, newest work, and that was fantastic, because it was Richard.
It also explains why our exhibition is both retrospective, it includes work which Richard has shown before in Scotland, but it also includes new work, because of their nature, you know, dialogues are unfinished, and hence we felt that it allowed us to both explore what Richard's achievement has been, but also to point out that in itself is unfinished, it goes on.
You are welcome to see 10 Dialogues exhibition from 29th of November 2010 till 9th of January 2011. This is Joanna Zawadzka, reporting for Polish Cultural Festival Association.